Hey guys, Jasmine Rae here, live on the lot. Now, it's not often that you can come across an album that grabs you by the arm, then reaches down your throat and wrenches your heart like this one. That is what the New Zealand Herald had to say about our next guest's latest project. So, Tami Neilson has won 4 Tuis Awards and also Female Artist of the Year, Country Song of the Year, the list goes on, I need some help, Best Country Song, Country Album of the Year, and also the very prestigious APRA Silver Scroll Award for Songwriting Excellence. You very much are at the top of your vocal and lyrical game at the moment. Oh my God. We are so excited to have you here to chat to us and to perform for us live on the lot. Tami Neilson, thank you for coming.
Thanks for having me. Hi, I'm Tami Neilson, and you're watching Live on the Lot on Skippy TV. We're going to do a track for you called Holy Moses.
Losing my mind from losing your love. Rapes in my eyes through the skies above. But I don't find nothing, don't feel nothing but alone. No time to cry when the babies need feed and days flying by with nothing new in between them. My soul is wearing thin. Time stretches on a fool's marathon ever since the day that you done gone. Holy Moses.
Holy Moses.
Holy Moses. Ooh, ooh, wee. Have mercy on me. Holy Moses,
holy Moses,
holy Moses, ooh, ooh, wee. Have mercy on me, have mercy on me. Ain't no let up, no get up and go. Don't wanna raise my weary head from my pillow, 'cause it's bad in my luck. Got stuck somewhere on down the road. Can't be bothered picking up my phone. I wish the whole damn world would just leave me alone. Stop knocking on my door. But nobody can see this burden on me. Back breaking, no one else gonna carry. Holy Moses.
Holy Moses.
Holy Moses. Ooh, ooh, wee. On me, I cry, holy Moses,
holy Moses,
holy Moses, ooh, ooh, wee. Have mercy on me, have mercy on me. Losing my mind from losing your love, raising my to the skies above, but I don't find nothing, don't feel nothing but alone. No time to cry when the babies need feed, 10 days flying by with nothing new in between them. My soul is wearing thin. Time stretches on a fool's marathon ever since the day that you knocked on. Holy Moses.
Holy Moses.
Holy Moses. I cry, holy Moses,
holy Moses,
holy Moses, ooh, ooh, wee. Have mercy on me, 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 good God, have mercy on me.
Is this your first time here in Australia?
I've been in Australia before, but I've only kind of hopped over to kind of play a one-off festival and then go home, or came when I first moved to New Zealand from Canada, came and did the little tourist thing and went to the Opera House. And,
okay,
you know,
cool.
So, but I haven't done a proper tour, haven't really been here to kind of have a proper chat with you guys. So
yes.
It's really exciting to be here.
It is super exciting to have you. And I don't think there has been anyone quite like you that has come to our shores.
Ooh.
It's very, yeah, it's alien really invasion. Exciting. I hope. Kind of. Less scary. So your accent and all your awards, it doesn't add up, does it? Your awards are all from New Zealand. Your accent is
Canadian.
Is Canadian. Yes. So you obviously jumped across the ocean.
I did. The tide was low, so I just kind of like walked over. And I grew up in Canada in a family band called the Neilsons, because that was our name. Very original.
Tami Neilson.
And for the better part of a decade, I was touring with my mom and my dad and my brothers, and did that most of our lives. And then I, you know, that old story, fell in love, that old chestnut. And
so was it on the
New
road
Zealander.
That you, so?
No, it actually wasn't. It was, I was off the road, and a girlfriend who married a Kiwi moved
so
to
New
Zealand.
So it was fashionable too.
Yeah. I'm like, she's got one. Yeah. I got to get one. I got to get one of those.
Really
yeah.
cool. And so was he touring at the same time? Was
oh,
he music,
God,
musical?
No.
No.
My poor husband, he can't carry a tune in a bucket. God bless him. He's good at many other things, but singing is not one of them.
Well, you carry the tunes for both of them. I actually went on a YouTube deep dive of the Neilson family band.
It's a dark place.
And no, it was amazing. And because I thought it was over a decade, because I actually got to see you grow up into this wonderful woman that you are now.
Oh, don't you love, it's pretty much, it's the equivalent of having your most embarrassing home videos for the world to see. Yeah. All the bad hairdos.
In a musical. It was, guys, you should know.
No, you shouldn't.
No.
And now they're going to. Thanks, Jasmine. Yeah, great.
But from there, and now, so your latest album is not your first album. So how many albums have you put out since
I guess I'm
the family band?
Five albums in as a solo artist.
Damn,
yeah.
I love it.
My latest album has a very special and different and deeper place in my heart. Mm-hmm. It was an album that was written in the wake of losing my dad very suddenly. And so the album, it kind of became this personal mission for me. It was a way to process my grief and kind of feel close to him, but also keep, you know, celebrate his life, keep his legacy alive, and build on the foundation that he'd worked so hard to provide for us as a family growing up. When we were losing my dad, the last thing I said to him was, you know, don't worry, I will be your voice, and not a note of your music is going to go to waste. And this album was keeping that promise.
Yes.
So it definitely became this kind of personal mission. But it's also something that I feel really privileged that I could process my grief in a really tangible way. Not a lot of people get to do that. You're kind of at this loose end and frustrated that there isn't something you can do to kind of get through this. And this was something I could pour everything into. And at the end, I had something I could actually hold in my hands and something that I could give to I have two boys who were very young when he died. And so for me, it was kind of being able to give that to them and say, this is your papa.
Yeah.
That album, I guess, really transcends all of the others for that reason.
Wow.
Yeah.
So the album is called Don't Be Afraid.
Yeah.
And what made you choose that as the title track?
Well, that was the very last song that my dad ever wrote in the hospital. And he was hooked up to life support. He had, it was a lung condition, so he could barely speak, let alone sing. And he, you know, had an oxygen mask. And so for him, it was a terrifying situation for him to be in. And the song Don't Be Afraid was like, my dad was a really strong man of faith. So for him, it was, you know, God speaking to him, don't be afraid, I'm with you, I'll see you through another day. But for me, it's flipped, you know, since he's left and I sing this song, it's my dad speaking to me about going on without him. Don't be afraid.
Yes.
I'm with you. And I'll never leave you. You're my child. You belong to me. And so the song kind of took on this whole other, it takes on a whole new form when I perform it. Mm-hmm. But when he was in hospital, he'd written all the lyrics out, and there's nothing worse for a songwriter than to have a melody in your head and you can't put it down, and you just, you don't want to lose it, so you keep going over and over in your head. And he was, you know, he had it all in there, but couldn't get it out. So I said, I'm going to bring your guitar in tomorrow and we'll record. You can even play the melody. At least we'll have it down and then it can stop driving you nuts, you know? And so I brought it in, and my dad, being my dad, he wanted to sing it. So he sang the first verse and all his levels dropped. So I said, okay, that's enough. We'll do the rest tomorrow. And unfortunately, we lost him the next day.
Wow.
But that verse that he recorded bookends the album. It starts with his song, with me singing it, and then finishes with him singing that verse, which I feel is really powerful. And I guess writing the album really kicked off when, because at first I just thought, nah, I can't do it. I can't even imagine opening my mouth to sing because his voice comes out of me. My voice is very much my dad's. And I had the studio time, had booked it months and months before, and had people flying back to work on it and produce and play on it. And my mom said, "What are you going to do about the album?" It was in 6 weeks from when I got back after he passed away.
That's so quick, isn't it?
It was really, really quick. And I just said, "Oh, I can't. I'm just going to cancel it. It's just too much." And she started to cry and said, "Your father would want you to do it. I think you should do it." I'm like, "I think he'd give me a break, Mom. Just cut me some slack here, woman. God." But I think what really flipped it was, you know, that song, he had such a, you know, this burning passion about that last song he was writing. And so Jay and I took what we had, the melody of the first verse, and then worked on the rest of the song and completed it and sang it at his funeral, which I still don't know how we did that to this day.
Wow.
But
and so you worked
that kicked it off to kind of go, this is the direction, this is going to help me to kind of keep my promise to him. Yeah.
That's when I did hear that his version at the end of the album, I just thought it does take it to a whole other level as a listener too, getting to know you. And also, you know, everyone has, well, or may eventually lose someone that they love. And so it's something that's so personal, but yet so universal. And so I feel like you've really, that's something so special about this album. So you speak about Jay. Jay is your brother.
Yes, sorry.
And so he is also, he'll be there on the deep dive if you will. What does Jay play in the Neilson family?
He's guitar, yeah.
Cool. And so did you mainly just write the tracks together for this album or just that?
Yeah, well, some of the songs we kind of tend to, I'll write something and then say, oh, can you, you know, tweak this so it's not so predictable, and he'll magic up whatever, you know, some different chords, because I'm a little bit limited compared to him, and
we don't believe you.
Yeah,
that's okay.
Hey, yeah, but so I'll either write the songs myself, or he and I. That process was a very different one to what I'd ever done. Once I decided, okay, I need to do this, I need to make this album, we sat down in a room together before I had to go back to New Zealand, and I just said, okay, I just want you to, let's just write some music and some melodies that I can take away with me and just kind of fill my treasure chest full of little scraps that I can then work on. And so we literally were sitting there just playing melodies, singing, and then I go, right, next, and keep that, and then I could, you know, kind of hammer it out and refine things. And so it was some of those songs. It was songs that my dad had written or started writing. Songs.
So how did
that
you find those songs that your dad had started?
Well, the writing? One, so there was obviously the last one that he'd written, Don't Be Afraid, but then another track on the album called Lonely is a song that my dad had written when he was in his early 20s. He must have been about 21. And being in a family band, growing up in a family band, I thought I'd heard everything that my dad had ever written, even ideas that he had kind of half-formed. I thought that I'd heard everything, and so did Jay. And we were, the week after he passed away, on his desktop, he'd left a folder saying, you know, song ideas or demos. And he knew that I was in the middle of writing for the next album.
Wow.
And he dug that out, and it was on his desktop. And we started listening to them, and most of them, you know, we were very familiar with all of the songs. And then this song came on, and Jay went, "What's this?" And I said, "I don't know. I've never heard this one." And he sounded so young. And that was the song that ended up being the song Lonely.
Yes.
And so we kind of took, you know, some of the lyrics, pardon me, and rewrote them and kind of made it full circle. Dad had written it. Oh, so we called Mum in and said, "What is this? When did he write this?" And you could hear kind of birds twittering in the background. And she said, "Oh, he wrote that when he had to go away on his first tour right after we got married. And we were missing each other. And he wrote this song about missing me. And he was outside his hotel room at a picnic table. That's why there's birds."
Wow.
And so we took it and wrote the lyrics about then her missing him and us missing him. And so it was kind of, it's a really, really special song.
It is an amazing song. And you perform it for us today.
Yes,
I will. So that's really exciting.
Hi, I'm Tami Neilson, and you're watching Live on the Lot on Skippy TV, and we're going to do a song for you off of my latest album called Lonely.
Lonely, where's the clothes left in your drawer? Lonely, won't let me go to places we went before. Lonely makes me walk in the rain. With lonely shade and cigarettes, and lonely looks like photographs of when we met. Lonely sprinkles dust on your guitar. And lonely keeps the tank full in your car. Please.
this is a magical album, Don't Be Afraid. Thank you so much for sharing it with us and for playing some songs for us and
making
us all cry and making the whole of Australia
cry.
It really is a pleasure having you on. Thank you so much.
Thank you.